So one of the companies that I run, Subatomic Analytics, mainly does digital analytics. And so I get a lot of like requests from people about how to get into digital analytics. And one of the group of people that I get quite a few requests from are students. And occasionally I do sort of mentor students to get into digital analytics. So they're studying for a degree, but they want to eventually get into digital analytics, especially if they're doing a degree that's not potentially has any sort of analytics in it. So for example, one person I'm sort of mentoring is doing a business degree, but they would like to get into digital analytics. It's stuff, something that they've learned about in their course. And they sort of approached me and said, how do I go about getting into digital analytics? So I'm sort of mentoring them through that process. And in the past, I've also done the same. I've mentored quite a few people into getting into digital analytics. And some of them have gone on from digital analytics to become data strategists or become data scientists. And so in this video, what I hope to do is sort of give you a step-by-step guide, I guess, into how to get into digital analytics. Really interested in digital analytics, the first thing you need to learn is the digital analytics tool, okay? So there are essentially two major tools in the marketplace. One is Google Analytics and one is Adobe Analytics. There are others, and I won't mention them for now, but you should really focus on the two core ones. And the one that's obviously freely available is Google Analytics, because Adobe Analytics usually requires a license, and unless you're working for a company that has access to Google Adobe Analytics, then it's going to be very hard to learn on Adobe Analytics. So the first thing is to learn the tool, and I would recommend that you start off with Google Analytics. Now, if you learn Google Analytics, you'll be able to use all the other tools. There are some slight differences, but to be honest, if you can learn Google Analytics, the other tools are easy to learn. In order to learn Google Analytics, the first point that I tell everyone is to do the Google Analytics Academy, okay? This is different to the Google Data Analytics course, okay, which talks about data analysis. This is about the Google Analytics Academy, where they teach you about Google Analytics and also Data Studio and about a Google Tag Manager. Now, the reason I ask people to do that course is because it shows me if they're committed to wanting to be a data analyst. It's a very simple course. They claim that there's about six courses there, four which are related to Google Analytics, but I would recommend you do all six of them. And apparently they take 8 hours each. Now, if you're a student and you committed a couple of hours a day, you should get through each course in a week, right? Okay. And what that shows me is that how committed you are, okay? Because then it also tells you if digital analytics is right for you, okay? Because if you're not willing to do those courses, then maybe digital analytics is something that you can't get into, okay? So I always say do the Google Analytics Digital Analytics Academy and see how it goes. Now, let's say you at least get through the four, then it shows that you have some interest in Google Analytics. Now, the next thing you have to learn is how is that data collected, okay? You learn a bit about it in the course, but you should also try and work it out in a very practical way. Now, the way to do that is essentially open up your own Google Analytics account and get the JavaScript code that you would then place in the page. Now, if you don't know how to create websites, I would probably pause your training and go off and learn how to create a website, because you should be able to today, you know, with all the tools like Wix and WordPress, be able to create a basic website, okay? And the reason I say that is because you need to know how that data is collected. If you don't understand how the data is collected from websites, okay, then you will struggle to be a digital analyst. You don't necessarily have to worry about how data is collected from apps. That's something that you will learn in the journey, and I'll talk about a bit later on. But what you are interested in is how websites collect data, because that's the easiest thing to learn. So like I said, if you don't know how to create a website, I'd pause your digital analytics training, go off and look at something like Wix or WordPress and create a website, okay? Create a few pages, just put it full of random stuff, but create a website, and it's free. A lot of these things are free if you don't ask for the advanced functionality. So just create a basic website. Then what you want to do is take your JavaScript code that you get from your Google Analytics account and put it into those websites. Now, if you know HTML, then you would actually paste the whole code into each of your pages, but actually it's much easier now. If you got a WordPress site, then you just need the account details of your Google Analytics and you just put that into WordPress, and WordPress will generate the rest of the code and you'll start seeing data come into your analytics account. So what you want to do is create these basic websites. It can be 4 or 5 pages, not much, and then go and visit them, okay? And then what you'll see is data coming into your Google Analytics account, okay, and you get an idea of, oh, actually, you know, this is what kind of data I see when I visit my website, okay? And you know what? It's not hugely informative. It's not designed to be hugely informative. What this exercise is designed to do is show you the relationship between putting a JavaScript code on a website and then seeing that data turn up in your Google Analytics account. That's what you're trying to experience, okay? Because that gives you a good appreciation for how data is collected from websites. Okay, now, once you've understood that, you've got a good feel for Google Analytics, ideally what you want to do next is find out how that data gets triggered, okay? Now, if you've tagged your own website, you can do it on that, but I would recommend you find another website that's got Google Analytics, or actually can have any tracking code on it, and you want to download some kind of browser extension which will help you debug the kind of events that are being fired from your website. So what happens is when you load a web page, okay, lots of events are being fired. Some of it's like drawing in images, other things are functionality, other JavaScript. Amongst all of that will be the tracking code, okay? And there are lots of tracking code, okay? There's not just website tracking code like GA, there'll be ad tracking codes, there'll be Facebook tracking code. But extensions to browsers or applications that you can get that attached to browsers can let you filter. So you can filter on Google or Adobe. But normally, if you want to find out what code's on there, all you need to do is right click on a web page, view source, and it will show you the code behind the page. And in there, you will either see, usually at the top, whether it's a Google Analytics tracking code, an Adobe tracking code, or some other tracking code, okay? But you should usually find out that the Google one will say Google, and it will start UA something, okay? So once you know that the website's either tracked with Google or Adobe or another solution, in your sort of browser extension, when you're debugging it, you can filter for just Google Analytics codes, and you'll see events being fired off. You'll see data being sent back to Google Analytics when you load a page. So if you actually been to the page, if you go to the page and then you do the debugging code, you'll see nothing because the page is loaded. So just press refresh F5 or on the top button of the top of the browser, there's like a refresh button. Press that and the browser will refresh, the page will refresh, and you'll see all those things being fired off. Now, it doesn't always work. Sometimes they cache, so you won't see it. But typically, you'll see that the events for analytics will fire off. And what that tells you is what kind of information is being collected. Now, when you look at analytics, okay, digital analytics, okay, what you have to bear in mind and the things you will learn is that there are some metrics like visit, okay, they're not things that are measured, okay, from the website. They're things that are inferred. So, for example, a visit is inferred from the time you spent on a website. A visitor is inferred from the number of cookies that are placed on your browser for that website, okay. Other things, however, page name, event names, submissions of forms are tracked explicitly. You see that those events are fired. So you will see something like page name equals and the page name is being populated. That means that value for the page name, whether it's home, whether it's product pages, whatever it is being sent to Google Analytics. And if you go to Google Analytics and you go to the page name report, you will see the page name home, product. If no one's explicitly tagged it, then typically it will either pick up the header of the page, or it will just give you the URL, okay? Or the URL, usually the URL after the main domain, so whatever the /. So homepage would just be /, and then it might be /, product_page, /, contact, _us, that kind of stuff, okay? So there is a default. And again, what I'm trying to get you to learn here is that when you're doing this kind of debugging, you're getting an appreciation of how that data goes from the website to Google Analytics. And more importantly, when something goes wrong, okay, how you can find out that something's gone wrong. So let's say, you go to a website and the page name says, laptop, Dell laptop, okay? But you go to Google Analytics and there's no page name called Dell laptop, okay? You can actually debug that. You can go back to that page, use the browser extensions to debug and see what event's being fired off, okay? Because what you might find is that in that page there's no code, so there's nothing being fired off, or it's been mislabeled, or it's picking up another value rather than Dell laptop page name, it's picking up something else, okay? What it allows you to do, like I said, is appreciate how the data goes from the web page to Google Analytics and where errors can occur, because not everything happens brilliantly. I mean, if you ask any digital analyst, okay, so if you are interested in digital analytics, speak to other digital analysts, and what they will tell you is actually a lot of the time things break, okay, and at the job of the digital analyst, you've got to be quickly troubleshoot that, find out why it's broken, advise the developers to fix it, and then you can carry on with your reporting. Again, here, when you're looking to how to debug issues, you're not trying to be an expert in fixing it. That's what the developers will do. Your job is to identify the problem and then tell the developers that this is broken, it needs to be like this, and they'll go off and do it. So at this stage now, like I said, you've learned Google Analytics, you've learned how to put a tag on a page, and you've learned how to debug issues or understand how data flows. So therefore, when you don't see the right data, you can actually identify what the problem is, okay? And those kind of things are quite fundamental in being a digital analyst. And at this stage, if you find all of this is too technical, then you're probably not, digital analytics is probably not right job for you, okay? Because these are the kind of stuff that you would do in the early days of being a digital analyst. So if you're a student doing your degree and you want to become a digital analyst, if you can't get your head around or you can't motivate yourself to do these kind of activities, then you should stop. Digital analytics is not a career for you. Okay, so if you enjoy all of that, then that's great, okay? You know, definitely digital analytics is a career for you. So you enjoy troubleshooting, enjoy tagging the website, understanding how GA works. That's brilliant. Okay, so now you need to move on to the next stage, because you've got the foundations of it, which is like technically you can run analysis. But what you need to now get is some kind of practical experience. You need to know how that is applied. Okay, so learning stuff, you know, like GA in a very theoretical context is great. It gives you the confidence that you can use the tool, but you really need to use it in an applied setting. And if you want to give yourself an advantage in the marketplace when you apply for a digital analytics role, you need to have some kind of practical experience. Now, ideally, what I would suggest is that you try and get an internship with a company and do some digital analytics for them. Okay, now the larger companies will usually have a digital analytics team, so reach out to those teams and see if you can get an internship, whether it's a week or 2 weeks even, if you can, and work with those teams, because they're the best experience. You might want to also look for agencies or consultancies who can offer internships. So my company, for example, I've taken on people who want to learn digital analytics, especially the people I mentor. I've helped them get some placements with my company, but also with other companies to learn digital analytics in an applied setting. And that's probably the best way to do it, when you've got other people that you can bounce ideas off. Now, I appreciate, again, getting an internship is really hard. It's not going to be that easy for everyone. So what you might want to do is then look for companies that aren't that great, that aren't that big, and approach them to see if you can, you know, do help them with their digital analytics. Now, it may be the case that they have someone, or they have someone who's part of their role with digital analytics. So you want to try and find them, approach them and say, you know, you're learning to be a digital analyst, you're a student, and you'd like to get some work experience in this space, and try and see if you can help them, with their digital analytics needs. Sometimes you might even find a company that hasn't even got digital analytics on its website, or it has, but it's not using it. So that's great. Okay, you can tell them, look, I can help you with all these kind of things. I can help you understand how many people are coming to your website, how long they're spending, what pages they're going to, and this can help you improve your website, improve your business, and so forth. Okay, so what you want to do is trying to get some work experience with those companies and help them. Now, if you can't get it with a company, then the next thing you do is just like I said, if you can't get it with any company, then what you can do is see if any of your friends or family have a small business that has a website that you can actually put Google Analytics code on and do some analysis. Because what you really need is real world data. You need people coming to the website in real term, not artificial, not you testing the website and generating data, but actual people coming to the website for a purpose, okay? So they've come for a purpose, and therefore you actually get real journeys of how people use the website, okay? So that's, if you can't get in a company, can't get an internship or any work experience, then yeah, you know, try and see if you can help friends or even local businesses that potentially have a website but haven't got a Google Analytics code on it, or if they did, they're not using it. Okay, see if you can help them. Like I said, also approach consultancies and agencies, but you do need some practical experience, because when you apply for a job, that will give you much more of an edge than everybody else, especially entry-level digital analytics role, where most people may know the tool, but they haven't got any practical work experience. Okay, so I would recommend you do get that work experience. And the reason for the work experience is not, I mean, it's great to have it on your CV, but it's actually to understand how a business asks questions, so that you can then use the digital data, the website data, to answer those questions. Okay, now in terms of apps, so a lot of data, you know, a lot of digital analysts also track apps. They're slightly different, but the principles are the same. They pick up events, they pick up actions, and they pick up metrics from those apps, but they're tracked slightly different. And again, it's not for you to learn now. Learn when you've got the job, okay? But it's to do with putting in SDKs and being able to hook the analytics into the actual native app and getting events fired back, okay? So again, stuff you can learn when you've got the jobs, but if you know how to use GA, you'll find a lot of the metrics that come out of the apps are very similar. There are some differences, but you'll find that, you know, they're not that difficult to learn if you know how to use GA in the first place with websites. So as I was saying, you know, you are trying to do the work experience because you're trying to understand what kind of questions businesses have and how you go about answering it. Because businesses very rarely say, look, I'd like to know how many visitors to my website. They do sometimes, but it's rare. Most of the time they say, I want to know how my website performed over Christmas. And, you know, you've got to decipher what performed means, okay? Even you've got to decipher what over Christmas means. For some companies, Christmas is literally the 5 or 6 days leading up to Christmas. For other companies, it's like a month leading up to Christmas. For other companies, it's a month before and a month after. That's their Christmas period. So you have to also, you know, you have to understand when companies give you that kind of vague brief, you know, you have to interpret it into solid and tangible data requests that you can ask of Google Analytics, okay? And then performance, you know, what is performance? Is it visitors? Is it page views? Is it time spent? Again, you need to clarify. For different businesses, different things. For some businesses, it just may be the ultimate objective, which is, did I sell more things, okay? So you're looking at conversion funnels and goals. If you learn the tool, if you learn Google Analytics, you learn how it's tagged, you sort of learn how to debug issues or understand how data is being sent across from the website to Google Analytics. If you get some work experience, real world work experience, like I said, great for your CV, but great for you to understand how businesses ask questions, then you are pretty much have the foundation to start applying for digital analytics roles when you graduate. Now, the final thing I add is whatever you do, whether you do digital analytics or you become a data analyst, or even if you become a data scientist, you have to learn Excel. I have yet to come across a scenario where sometimes or a lot of the time you're going to take the data from GA, from whatever, and you're going to put it into Excel and you're going to transform it and then put a graph chart or even create a report in Excel. Okay, so try and learn Excel as well. If you're a student, you should have access to Excel from your university, and try and learn Excel. Try and learn the basics of how to run, you know, add stuff up, how to summarize things, how to create pivot tables, how to do VLOOKUP, XLOOKUPs, that kind of stuff, okay? So try and understand the basics of how to use Excel. Again, the more advanced stuff you learn when you get the job, but you need to know the basics, okay? Because companies will expect it of you, okay? So try and learn Excel, and at least you can put on your CV that you're proficient in at least doing the basics in Excel. Finally, the question is going to be, why do you want to be a digital analyst? So give yourself a good reason why you want to do it. Why did you start this journey? Is it because you're interested in digital technologies and you want to know how data can improve digital experiences and make companies more money? Is it because you're interested in data? Is it because you're interested in web technology? What is it that you're interested in? And why did you want to become a digital analyst? Because that's a lot of the time graduates are asked why they want to enter this field, okay? Because the last thing a hiring manager wants to do is hire someone because they just saw the job advert and decided to apply for it. But hopefully, if you've done things like the Google Analytics Academy, you've learned a bit about GA, you've learned about tagging, you've learned about Excel, you've got some work experience, then it will show that you're serious anyway. Okay, but it's always good to have a reason why you want to be a digital analyst. Okay, so if you are a student and you would like to become a digital analyst, I hope this video helps you understand the kind of steps that you need to take in order to get yourself in a good position to apply for digital analytics roles once you've graduated. And in fact, you could actually apply for digital analytics role while you're still a student if you have the time and you feel you could do this alongside your studies. Then there's no reason why you couldn't do it part-time. There's a lot of need for digital analysts on a part-time basis. They don't necessarily need to be on a full-time basis. You know, there's things like companies that just need reports every Monday morning or every Monday, Monday afternoon even. So if you've got that time free, you can work over the weekend, you can work some evenings, then there's no reason why you can't try and apply for part-time digital analytics roles. And again, sometimes these roles may not be advertised, but you may, like I said, connect with companies and ask them for roles that you could potentially do part-time. And you sometimes find that people haven't thought about it because they've always thought, I need a full-time digital analyst, but I haven't got enough work for a full-time analyst. So, you know, what you might find is that you solve a problem that they've had about hiring a part-time digital analyst. And it'd be great for you because you've already started the journey. And then what you'll find is that if you've got that experience, it's much easier then once you've graduated to get into a full-time digital analyst role. Okay, so I hope you enjoyed watching this video. If you have any comments, please put them in the comments section below. Please do like the video and of course do subscribe to my channel. Thank you.
Whether it's on the email or on the YouTube comment section about people who are already in a job and they're asking, how do I become a data analyst while I've already got a full-time job or I've got family commitments?
What sort of the steps do I need to go through and how long should they generally take for me to become a data analyst?